Hey guys, a lot has happened since the last time I had made a video, and I had a birthday in July, on July 31st, so I'm now 20 years of age. And my brother was so nice, he actually got this for me so I can make videos easier. It's a cute little director's cut thing. So today I had a good idea about making a video that is unrelated topics to Disney, believe it or not, because I can't constantly be talking about Disney, even though I could be talking about Disney constantly. But there's been a couple of things that I've wanted to talk about, and these are it. Oh, number one, I don't know if you all know this. Oh, wait, before I talk to you, let's go back to Disney things. Shirt for my, yeah, it was pretty much for my birthday. And it's of Olaf that says, "Some people are worth melting for." How nice. Well, I'm not as crazy about Frozen as everyone else is, but I do really enjoy the movie. I actually got it for my birthday. I was gonna show it to you, but I have no idea where it is. I thought it was in here, but it's not. So the first thing I wanted to talk about that is unrelated to Disney is that the other day, Anne Rice gave over the rights to all of her books, that is the Vampire Chronicles, to Universal so they can make them movies. And I'm still trying to decide how I feel about that. Mostly because I have been a fan of her books for a while now. I started reading the Vampire Chronicles when I was about, oh my gosh, I was pretty young. I think it was at least 12. Which wasn't really that long ago, but still. It was long ago to me. I've only had a short life. It's still trying to sink in that they are going to make these classic books, classic vampire books, into movies. They did great with Interview with a Vampire. I thought that was amazing. Tom Cruise was amazing as Lestat. And Brad Pitt was amazing as Louis. And Kristen Dunst was fabulous as Claudia. Even though Antonio Banderas was Armand. Don't get me wrong, I love Antonio Banderas, but having him play Armand, okay, Armand is supposed to be this, like, this 17-year-old Russian redheaded kid, and you know what, I'm not even gonna go into that. And they also made another movie called Queen of the Damned, which I have not personally seen, but I have seen like a little bit of clips, and I'm just like, the only thing that gives me solace is that Anne Rice's son did a screenplay for The Tale of the Body Thief, and that gives me hope that it'll be a good movie. Mostly because when they did an Interview with a Vampire, Anne Rice did the screenplay, and it was fabulous. I just love the series so much. I'm actually reading The Vampire Lestat for the third or fourth time around, because I just wanted to get a feel for this amazing character again. And mostly because I know that Prince Lestat is going to be out later this year, and I just wanted to see how much he changed, I guess, so I'm reading that book again. So if there's one thing that I could say to Universal, just don't screw it up, okay? Just don't do it. Because Tale of the Body Thief is my favorite book out of the series. It's my favorite book. That besides the book I'm reading now, The Vampire Lestat. It's just hard. It's hard for a book reader, a really passionate book reader, to see their favorite books being made into films, because you finally get to see these characters alive, and it's kind of frightening because you've had these ideas of what they're like. That's probably why some of these movies could turn out so badly, is because everybody has their own ideas of what these characters look like and act like and talk like, and so when they see these films and they're just completely different, they're just like, this is awful, this is not what I was picturing at all, because everybody has their own thoughts on the matter.
One of the things that kind of irked me just a little bit is I was reading one of the articles about how they were just, everybody was announcing Anne Rice has given over the rights to Universal, and they said it could be like a Twilight fan, like it could blow up like Twilight did, or something related to Twilight, and I'm just like, does anybody realize how long The Vampire Chronicles has been out? Like, way, way before I was born. It's like in the 70s that these came out. And just to hear that it could blow up like Twilight is just like... Do you have any idea who Anne Rice is? Anne Rice has made these vampires. She's like the queen of the modern vampires. Like, she started all of this vampire craze stuff. So to say, like, she's like, it could be like Twilight, it's blown up already. It's beyond Twilight. Twilight is... I am actually writing a book, believe it or not. I've had this idea, I have tons of ideas for books, but this idea has stuck around for a really, really long time, and probably years I've had this idea. All of a sudden, this goes back to Anne Rice, I was watching an interview, it was on Anne Rice's YouTube channel. I was kind of binge watching Anne Rice things, maybe. Well, because I admire her so much, okay? Don't judge me. So I was watching a video of her giving writing advice, and she was saying, if there was any advice that I could give, just write. That's all I can say. Just write. Whether it's just a page or a paragraph or a chapter a day, just get something out there. And so it really, really kind of hit me in the face. Wow, that's pretty... I mean, it's as basic as that. So, I've started writing it, and it's kind of crazy because these characters are actually real. Like, I feel like they're real. Like, they speak through me. It's a weird experience. And I had this crazy moment where this really larger-than-life character that I've created just kind of. I saw his face for the first time while we were just driving. Me and my family were just driving back from somewhere, and I just saw it. It was so crazy, and I can understand why writers like to write so much, just because these experiences are crazy. Sometimes thinking about being successful and being successful and getting to where you actually want to go is very hard to imagine. And I feel like some people, when they finally get it, they don't realize what they really wanted. And that's a scary thought sometimes, because there can be times when you want something so badly, and when you finally get it, you realize it's not what you wanted. Or it's not what you thought you wanted. If I was to ever become successful, I would treat people nothing less than equal. Even if they were just an intern or just a busboy or just anybody, why would you treat them anything less than equal? I mean, it just irks me sometimes. So in conclusion, two things to be exact. I went to go see the movie 100 Foot Journey today with my madre and my sister and my Grammy, and it was a very good movie. It was produced by Steven Spielberg and Oprah Winfrey. I highly recommend it.
if you like food. Oh my gosh, I was so hungry by the end of that movie. The second thing is I just wanted to tell you this short story. Yesterday was my first cousin's child. He's turning two. There you go. And we went to the beach. And there's a couple of other kids there, of course. It was his birthday party. And I was playing with the littlest girl. And she was just running around. And then I had, just grabbed her and picked her up because she was just running everywhere and making these really funny horse noises. She was acting like she was a pony. This guy walked by and was like, he was just like, yeah, I got a kid like that too, just a handful, huh? And I was just like, oh no, she's fine. And he just kind of walked away, and I was just like, I almost wanted to yell at him, she's not my kid, she's just, I'm just watching her, okay? It's funny how we just assume in this day and age that me being a 20-year-old, I would already have a kid. So, I don't know, I guess I just wanted to throw that out there. Crazy times we live in, my friends. Crazy times. Well, this is Jenna signing off. And I gotta think of a better sign off or something. Unrelated video out. Oh, I'm making a video!